Housing supply is on the rise, and so are home prices. Also, Korea has revised its home sales forecast for 2023. All that and more in this month's report. Hello, and thanks for tuning in. I'm your host, Matt Day, and with me is Korea's senior economist, Sean Cathcart. We have a jam-packed show for you this month since there's an update to the quarterly forecast, and we definitely want to set aside some time to go over those numbers. But first, let's get into how Canadian real estate markets fared in June 2023. Sean, the floor is yours.
Sure. Well, you know, in general, things seem to be settling down. Sales are leveling off and new listings are finally starting to play catch up. You know, up until about a month ago, the reason that sales rally lost so much steam after a single big gain in April was likely because new listings were at a 20-year low. And so all that demand couldn't be converted into sales. That's why, rather than just stabilizing, as many expected, prices actually took off again at a pace that was bested only by the hottest sellers markets during COVID. Now, that was true again in June with the MLS Home Price Index jumping another 2% month over month. That's a big gain, but I don't expect it to continue like that. Because firstly, we now have more properties coming available for sale finally, but also we have the Bank of Canada resuming rate hikes. Which will likely send some demand back to the sidelines in the second half of 2023. So more supply and less demand should calm down price growth, and it should be a more balanced, slower market over the second half of this year.
Okay. You mentioned rate hikes there, and we're fresh off a new one here in July. So can you explain the rationale a bit behind that?
Yeah, sure. Well, you know, everyone keeps saying July's hike was expected, whereas June's was a big surprise. I'd argue the June one should have been more expected than it was. Given that we knew a rate hike was coming. At that point, it was priced in 100% for July. But if you think about the bank's whole MO over the last year that they've been hiking rates, it's been, you know what, if this needs to happen, we're not going to wait. We're just going to do it right now. And so they pulled the July hike forward into June, and now they've pulled the expected September hike forward into July. And given that we won't hear an update from the bank again until the kids are back in school, they probably felt like there was more of a risk of not doing enough and then having things heat up again over the course of the summer.
Okay, so we can take a little break on the whole will they, won't they raise the rates debate for a bit there. So, but how does this all impact Canadian homeowners?
Well, one thing the bank did not do in this announcement, which they did do back in January, was give any indication at all that this was the top. On the contrary, they cited some concerning trends that could keep inflation high even longer than their newest forecast, which has inflation getting stuck over the next year and only getting back to target in mid-2025. And that's the hopeful soft landing version. So the other thing to think about is that borrowers out there is the cumulative impact of the last year and a half. So this latest 50 basis points of rate hikes will not be as easily absorbed as 50 or even 100, say, a year ago. So far, there have been surprisingly few signs of stress in the form of mortgage arrears, people reducing spending, et cetera. In fact, the bank even said in this release that one of the main issues and one of the main reasons for this latest rate hike is that people are still spending money like crazy. And you've seen that if you've been out and about. But I know policymakers have been wondering how close we are to the straw that breaks the camel's back for some mortgage holders. That's a big concern. With the big mortgage renewal numbers coming up in 2024, 25, and 26. Now, in the meantime, we've got a couple of months before the next rate announcement to look at the data for clues as to what the bank might do in September. And remember that after the April rate announcement, there were many observers that thought we would be seeing rate cuts as soon as like now. So a lot has changed, but that just means a lot can still change.
Yeah, which makes the playing the prediction game such a concrete science, right? This seems like a perfect segue to the latest Korea quarterly forecast figures, actually. As our viewers may know, Korea updates its annual forecast every few months to adjust for emerging trends and news. So how many revisions went on this time around?
All right, well, before I get into the details, I have to highlight two components of a forecast revision. Now, obviously, one is the sort of the trajectory going forward from where we are, which is the main component of a forecast. But the other component that we have to take into account here is what is the new starting point for that trajectory compared to 3 months ago, right? Now, because of the lack of supply in the market, our starting point for sales is lower, right? As we've already mentioned, that rally really lost steam. But also because of lack of supply in the market, our starting point for the average price in Canada is much higher. It shouldn't come as a surprise that we've downgraded the trajectory part for both sales and prices going forward with these higher rates for longer and the uncertainty that that creates, putting people to the sidelines again, as they did in 2022. But because our monthly starting point for the national average price shot up by over $100,000 just since our last forecast in the space of 3 months, we've actually raised the annual average price number, even though the trajectory going forward is lower, if that makes sense. It's worth explaining because it can get complicated. But so the numbers, we're looking at about 465,000 sales nationally this year compared to about 490,000 last forecast. A big enough downgrade, but it's not huge. That's still a below average year. It's still a recovery year. It's just going to be a slower recovery now. And remember, those sales are not necessarily gone forever. They're just gone for now until we see what rates do later this year and we get some certainty back in the market. And we're looking at a national average price of a little over $700,000 in 2023 compared to a forecast of about $670,000 back in April. So that's been raised up just because that starting point is so much higher. Now for the 2024 numbers, I'll just say we still expect some upward movement, not as much as before. But you know, the Bank of Canada did just say they think inflation will now be higher than they'd like into 2025, which is information we didn't have when we were putting this forecast together. It wasn't in the interest rate forecast at the time. So, you know, we'll see what happens next time around. We've got 3 months and we'll get a Bank of Canada a rate announcement before our next forecast. But I guess for now, over the summer, let's just all join the Bank of Canada in crossing our fingers for some more encouraging data over the next couple of months.
Yeah. Hey, I mean, hey, what's that old saying about trying to time the market? Seems like there's a lot of factors in play for the time being that will make things difficult to predict. So let's wrap up today's show. Let's recap some of the main points our viewers, you need to know. The Bank of Canada raised rates again in July, which is likely to send demand back to the sidelines. The MLS home price index was up another noteworthy 2% month over month in June. And CREA is now forecasting 465,000 home sales in 2023 and a national average price of $700,000. So less homes trading hands than previously forecasted, but at higher prices. Sean, I wish we could say we're also going to take a break for the rest of summer, but no, we'll be back next month with an update on Canada's real estate markets and trends. Thanks so much for your candid breakdown once again. Thanks to you for watching. And if you want more info, make sure to head to stats.crea.ca for more information about your market. See you next month.